today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. This is Madden Football on EA Sports. It's the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Well, the roof is closed, but as you can probably tell, the mouths of these Cowboy fans could not be more wide open. It is a frenzied AT&T Stadium in Arlington. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with Ben Roethlisberger and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Zuerlein now. He'll handle the honors to get us started. And off we go on EA Sports. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. Here are the Steelers making their way out, and with their longtime starter Ben Roethlisberger leading the way.
And for Ben Roethlisberger, there are a lot of question marks coming into this year because he missed nearly all of 2019 with an elbow injury. And if he were younger, maybe not as many questions. But he turned 38 back in March. And now the Pittsburgh Steelers expect to see the old Ben Roethlisberger, who's thrown for over 56,000 yards in his career, leading their team.
The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith, able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Jalen Smith tied for sixth in the NFL in tackles last year and on the stop there.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. That went into the hands of his tailback, Samuels. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. 27 yards there on a very nice third down conversion.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the right side to Eric Ebron. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second and 2, first down marker at the 5 yard line. Again, it's Roethlisberger. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. James Washington was the intended target, and it's third and short.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
And this will be play number 8 of the opening drive. It's third and short. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. This Cowboy defense looked ready for that third down pass. Brings up fourth.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it. And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll run for it with Connor, and nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And this crowd loves it as their guys hold on the opening drive. So here are the Cowboys now backed up to get this drive started. They'll be led out by their quarterback at 6'4 from Northwestern, Clayton Thorson.
It's pretty much become the norm when we see guys come out before a game and go through the route tree with their receivers. I thought it was exciting for us to see the exact same thing happen in practice.
He's so meticulous, isn't he?
He really is, and it's not just a one-time-a-week thing. They work on it all the time, trying to hone that fine edge. They want to see if they can get in sync and stay in sync in this one.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. They'll run with Elliott. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a third and about 7 left.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
And the Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. From the gun, it's Thorson. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Joe Hayden, the veteran, with a pick. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Here come the Steelers, the final undefeated team in the NFL this season, 7-0, sitting alone atop the AFC North after a big 4-point win in Baltimore. That was a classic AFC North defensive battle. The Steelers' defense sent the house after Lamar Jackson. 4 sacks, 2 interceptions, 2 fumble recoveries as well, and a late fourth down pass knocked down by Minkah Fitzpatrick that helped secure the win. Ben Roethlisberger on the offensive side was held in check early, but things got better for him in the second half. 182 yards and a couple of touchdowns in quarters 3 and 4. Now, Pittsburgh's schedule, it's going to cool off a bit now. They'll travel to Dallas, who certainly has been struggling before returning to Heinz Field to host Cincinnati with a division game. First and goal from the 3. They'll look to run with Connor. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
Chris Boswell now for the extra point. And he'll put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers. They had the short field and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Football going back to the 2-6 Dallas Cowboys, who suffered their third straight loss in Week 8, 23-9 on Sunday night in Philly. Their much maligned defense, that's what kept them in the game, but ultimately the moment proved too much for their third quarterback of the year, Ben DiNucci, the rookie seventh round pick. His first NFL start, really had a tough time moving the offense against Philadelphia. He finished with 180 yards passing, but could muster only three Greg Zuerlein field goals. That was it offensively for the Cowboys. Second straight game without a touchdown for this Dallas offense. And Ezekiel Elliott, only 63 yards rushing. He has yet to have a 100-yard game this year. That's hard to imagine at this point in the season. So you turn the page for Dallas. They will now host the league's only undefeated team, 7-0 Pittsburgh. So things don't get easier. Fortunately, after that for Dallas, they'll have an open week in Week 10. On third down, it's Thorson. Connects here with the tight end, Blake Jarwin. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Now Elliott. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Here's Thorson. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The rookie CeeDee Lamb, the intended receiver. But it'll be 2nd down. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Throwing, Thorson. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, and it's third down. Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10. Shotgun snap for Thorson. The Steeler defense locked in, forcing an upcoming fourth down. Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
After the made field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. Here's Kareth White on the return. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards.
And as you saw right there, this is a guy with pretty good speed for a tight end. Nice job there catching the short throw and turning it upfield. He could also be a weapon downfield as well.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. To throw here, Roethlisberger. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Ben leaves to counter on the draw. A little second effort there on the strong run. And then drop just inside of the 20. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. It's a first down following a gain of 3.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. That's complete, right around the 8. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Second down from the 8. They can get a first down by reaching the 5. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. This will be caught at about the 5. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Now here's Snell, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Boswell for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will make it into the end zone. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. They start on the ground with Elliott. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And they'll work from the 29 on 2nd and 6. Now Thorson. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
A first down carry by Elliott. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Behind the chain, second and 12. Thorson able to hit his target, Lamb. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Heavy set out there on third and one. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 8 yards, first down, as they're able to convert.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. He'll drop to throw. Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. That catch good for only a couple.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
The Cowboys on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. 10th carry now for Elliott. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. We've got a 14-3 ball game with 2 minutes left in the opening half. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
For the main field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no return here for White. It'll be a touchback. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Well, a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender. And that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Roethlisberger. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Oh, what is that?
Well, they looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Oh, yeah. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. On the crossing route, complete. That's Johnson. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Ben to throw again. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time, and it's second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw again is Roethlisberger. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Now the Steelers use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Now Roethlisberger to throw. Letting one go deep for the end zone. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Deontay Johnson, 26 yards. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
And that's certainly an important score right there, because they gave themselves a 2-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision, because they do have the final call now.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. And this one through the uprights and good. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Ezekiel Elliott gets ready to go again here on offense as he shuffles onto the field. He's had a good chunk of carries. Problem is, for very little success. I don't want to put it all on his shoulders, but that's a big reason they're losing right now.
Have to be very careful that he doesn't start pointing fingers. Offensive line obviously trying. The defense is doing a nice job against him today. When it's all said and done, it's all about the guy in the mirror. He has to get it done better going forward.
See if he can look and do some soul searching now. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. It's incomplete. Blake Jarwin, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And finally, down at the 36-yard line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Here's Thorson on first and 10. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And they're hanging around here as the lead's down to 12. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And no reason to do anything foolish as they'll snap it one more time on first down. He'll take the knee and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we come upon halftime in what's a 12-point game at the break. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We just watched a very good first half out of the veteran, Big Ben. He's thrown for over 200 yards already, and his guys have the lead as well. As we get you back to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. This is Tony Pollard. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. That catch good for only a couple.
Well, they were unable to make anything really big out of that, but it's not a bad idea to find your tight end and give him an easy completion and keep moving things forward. Almost as bread and butter as a good running back dive play.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. He'll fire this deep for Gallup. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And a good job on the tackle there as they get him down shy of the first on the 35-yard stripe.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down. And he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. I'm going to call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number two. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Roethlisberger setting up the screen. This is Samuels. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Yeah, the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. Now it's Roethlisberger. Ebron's got him. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 83 yards receiving now for him on the afternoon as he's got a first down here.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
Roethlisberger on first down. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. DeMarcus Lawrence picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
And that's the second sack of the game, but this player, Disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Now Roethlisberger. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Now Ben on third and long. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's fourth down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid gain.
Here's Jordan Berry now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
It's big Vince Williams who made the tackle.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Balled it to 26, second and 7. They go play action. Now Thorson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Thorson, play action. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he'll be pulled down as a penalty flag will rain in as well, and that would appear to be a face mask. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. To the right side, he's got Cooper. It's complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup there. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. From the gun, it's Thorson. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21.
Oh my goodness, was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Shotgun snap for Thorson. Over the middle, hauled in by Lamb. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for 4th down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the eight. So give him the first down, first and goal after a pickup of four, and the decision to go for it pays off. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Now Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys have cut it to within a score.
And that touchdown ends a streak, for lack of a better word, of three field goals that they put on the board previously. They finally cracked the code.
Yeah, they've been down there. They've been in enemy territory, as you said. They just hadn't been able to punch it in until that point. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is back to a five-point game. So this drive spans seven plays, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
Man, I've seen that play a couple of times already.
Here comes Ben Roethlisberger and the Steeler offense back onto the field. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They're like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
Well, CD, we are through 8 weeks of the 2020 NFL schedule. Now, 12 teams have played exactly eight games. The other 20, because of open weeks, will reach that number next week, week nine. But I want to go through a few of the teams with eight games, and you tell me where you think that they're going to finish up. Let's start with the Browns at 5-3.
And I thought that they'd be 6-2. I thought they beat Las Vegas last week, so due to inconsistency, I'm going to give them 9-7.
All right, same record right now, other conference. How about the Bears at 5-3?
The exact same thing, but only because of their offense. Again, 9-7.
All right, one more. 49ers who sit at 4-4 right now.
I think they've overachieved in a lot of ways based on all the injuries they've had, and they'll continue to battle and scrap. How about 8-8 for them for the season?
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. They'll try and get the running game going with Elliott. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Here's Thorson. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Thorson looks to throw on first down. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down.
My, oh, my, they've had some success bringing him off the edge. How about the gambling man who's the defensive coordinator? He's not just bringing pressure. He's bringing a corner to go after the quarterback.
And it's worked twice now, twice like a charm.
And not only has that worked like a charm, he's been awfully disruptive in his usual role covering receivers. Now he's rushing the passer as well.
Second and 14 as they've got work to do here after the sack. Throwing, Thorson. Able to hit his target run. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers 21. A gain of 28 yards there and give them a first down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
On first and 10, it's Thorson. Got an open man to tight end Jarwin. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Now Thorson. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
And that will be incomplete. And that went off the mark a little late with a throw. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. On fourth down, it's Thorson. And it's caught! And he's brought down. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Toss left to Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys have taken the lead. Now he's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there. But 2 TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come. Thorson. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
think we can figure out why they went for two there, right? Up one, you want to make it a field goal difference if at all possible. They didn't get it. Now they've got to play some defense down the stretch.
Yeah, not much margin for error now for your D. They just have to get it into range. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Here's White. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in.
And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. Jalen Smith, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The intended receiver out of the backfield was Jalen Samuels. And now it's third down.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
The Steelers on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be third and a mile. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. That one into the hands of his tailback, Samuels. And he'll go out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. But when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Ebron with it over the middle. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. To throw again is Roethlisberger. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28.
Nice play, man.
That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll be fourth down.
Well, plays like that, Charles, no doubt, they're just going to continue to fuel this crowd.
And this defense is already playing well, but it also feeds on the energy of that crowd that you're talking about, and that takes them up to another level. Right now, they're playing really loose. They've got the lead, and what a nice stop they just made there behind the line of scrimmage.
Here's Jordan Berry now. as he's on to punt for Pittsburgh. It's a 42-yard punt. They keep him to just a yard on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And here comes a big tight end as he gets set for this next drive. All right, Charles Davis, what do we make of these numbers and what's happened to the big tight end here?
Well, I think a lot of times we talk so much about adjustments and what you're going to do at halftime that maybe we miss what actually goes on, because the sense is that, oh, they go in at the half, they just change everything. That's not really true. A Super Bowl winning quarterback out of New York always used to say, you've worked all week on a game plan. There's a reason you have it. Just either play it better or make subtle tweaks to it. Otherwise, there's no sense even going into a ball game. A lot of times that's what they do. Just find a little subtle thing, one little change, and maybe it can make things a little bit better.
On play action, they'll throw. This to Jarwin. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Well, that was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. He's been busy, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And they will take a knee here. A 20th carry here for Elliott. Take this all the way down to the Steelers' 5. A big game there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to, and it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. Victory all but assured now as they take a knee here, and they're going to escape with a one-point victory.
And how about this finish? Able to take a knee, run out the clock, and close this game out.
by 1 point. You talk about how many coaches we talked to. They all said the same. All I want to do is win by 1 point. That got tested in this one.
Yep, and that cliche rings true. A single penny separates this one. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.